This demonstration focuses around tabs, which are very useful for lining up items into neat columns in your documents. Tabs are produced by hitting the tab key on your keyboard. As you can see, when I hit the tab key, at the moment there are preset tabs that moves across my document. Now these tabs to the human eye are invisible, however we can show some of the formatting marks on a document by on the Home tab, clicking on the Show Hide Formatting button. And you can see the tab keys that I've just pressed there have appeared, the formatting marks have appeared. When I hit the Enter key, you can see that Enter key press has been shown there. I'll just hit a few more tabs here, add Enter again, and tab, Enter. You can see all these formatting items that I put in can now be seen, and I can just quite as easily hide those. Gives a bit of insight into when a user is creating a document as to where the formatting is. Another formatting that may be placed in a document might be a page break might be forced, so there's a new page is forced, and you can see that the page break has been forced in there. And again, just to remind you, you can make that formatting disappear. Okay, I'm just going to remove all of the formatting from this document and we'll start again from scratch. Now I'm going to work on setting up some tab stops. What's useful when you are working with tabs and you want to measure your page carefully and correctly is to view the ruler. So over on the right hand side here, you can see there's a button there that can make the ruler on the page appear, and now we can measure out the page appropriately. So I'm going to set out four tab stops here, and to do that I'm going to go to the page layout area here and pop out the paragraph dialog box. Now there's an option there for tabs, so when I click on that, you can see I can set up tab stops on my document. The first tab stop I'm going to set up is after 1 centimeter, so I'll just type in 1. You can see the default tab stops there at 1.27 centimeters or 1 inch is what applied when I was tabbing across by using the tab key earlier. So the first one I'm going to do is set up a left aligned tab stop after 1 centimeter. So I'll set that. Next tab is, by typing in the tab stop position, I'll type 5 for 5 centimeters, and I'm going to make that center aligned. So I'll set that. So that's my second tab set up. I'll set up a third on 9 centimeters. That's going to be right aligned. And the final one on 12 centimeters, I will set as a decimal tab. Okay. So now you can see up in my ruler here, after 1 centimeter, the left aligned, the center aligned after 5 centimeters, after 9 centimeters, the right aligned, and the decimal tab, you can see there is on 12 centimeters. That's how it's represented visually on the ruler. Now let's go ahead and show my formatting. So I'll just show it again. And when I hit the tab key, you can see it automatically jumps out to that right aligned tab. And I'm going to make this my title row, so I'm just going to make it bold, type in name, and a tab to the center aligned tab. Department. Next area here is job title, which is a right aligned tab. Finally, I'm going to tab over to pay. Now I'm just going to hit enter here and jump onto a new line, as you can see there, and take off my bold. Now I'm going to tab under name, write in the name of my first employer. Tab over to his department, which you can see lines up centrally underneath it. And he's in the finance department. Over to his job title, which you can see starts to line up right aligned. And his pay. And I'm going to use the insert button here to find my euro sign. Which will be 25 euros per hour. Okay, just to give us a better idea, I'm going to start with a second employee here. and tab over. As before. And you can see a similar alignment appears. Now I'll just remove my formatting marks so we can see that more easily. And there we are. And see, for the left aligned and right aligned, you've edges lining up. The center aligned works like this, and the decimal tab lines up underneath the decimal point here, which is handy for monetary figures and such. Okay, now we have learned how to create tabs using figures. I'm going to start a new document and set tabs by using the ruler. So on this document here, I'm going to align up tabs myself. So I'm going to put in the same titles there again in bold. So I have name, just use the automatic tabs for now, department, followed by job title, and followed by pay. Okay, so I have no tab set up for this quite yet, so I'll just move over onto my ruler here, and our first tab is a left tab, so I'll just click at a 1 centimeter mark, and I'm going to tab my name over to that. The next tab I require was a center tab, which is in around 4.5-5 centimeter mark, so I'll just click here. Now, the next tab, which is a right align tab, you can see I can select the type tab by just clicking here and toggling through all the various options or types of tabs until I reach the one I require. So I've now found a right tab. You can see that when I mouse over and get my screen tip, it tells me it's a right tab. Then go into the tab stop position on the ruler. So for this one, I'll go to 8.5 centimeters, and you can see it tabs out for me there. Next one was a decimal tab, so I'll just toggle through again. There it is, decimal. I'm in around 12 centimeters, I can put the pay. So I'm now ready to jump onto the next line and tab away and put in my employee details as before. Oops, I'll just make sure I take away the bold writing from that. And tab away is normal. Inserting my currency symbol again. That's my tab alignment. Okay, the advantage of working on the ruler is that you can tweak things more easily. So say, for example, I feel this right align tab here would fit in better if it was in around a 10 centimeter back. I can simply just click on that particular tab and drag it over. Maybe a little bit more. Yeah, that looks much better. And just do the same for the title. Now, how would I do the two of them at once? I'll just undo that last move. If I wanted to move both tabs and both lines at once, I just simply select both lines at once prior to moving my tab. Now, when I move my tab, you can see it affects the tab stop on both lines rather than just an individual line. So there we go, that's tabs, a useful tool for lining up items in rows and columns on a document.